Transformational leadership is a process of creating, sustaining, and enhancing leader-follower, follower-leader, and leader-leader partnership with an aim to achieve a common vision in which leaders and followers serve together. Gemba class of 2013 took a step out of class in order to transform the society through the lives of children in Shades Orphanage in Riruta, Nairobi County. Shades Orphanage is a home of less fortunate children and was started more than a decade ago.
Natuliajisha na wao in 1986 when I started this project. Nafikiri tu wengi wenu tumeonana na nimeeleza kikamilifu vile nilianza, na nilianza project hii kwa sababu ya tabu ile niliona wakati nilitumwa hapa kufanya kazi hapa. Nilifanya kazi hapa miaka nyingi na nikaenda retire. Sasa wakati nilikuja nikaona iko watoto wengi sana kwa barabara, na nikauliza madamu yule alikuwa huko kwa ofisi zile kubwa, akaniambia ni nini unataka? Hai, nikamwambia wewe huoni? Wone kile ni mimi nataka. Watoto ni wengi kwa barabara na wakati tunasunguka na wewe unawaona. Kwa hivyo tafadhali nipatie proti hapa ili nijege watoto.
I'm here as part of the Gemba 13, which is the Global Executive Masters Business Administration from the United States International University, and we are here at Riruta Shade Orphanage to just come and unite with the community here, which is an orphanage for orphans and vulnerable children. We have come to be able to transform the community here. That we looked at Riruta Shade Orphanage as a prime location that will be able to interact with the children and even show them the transformation that is from the current breed of readers, of leaders, sorry.
Wageni wa Gemba tumepanda nao mboga, wameturenovate ya hall, alafu leo wamekam for medication, kuangalia check up. Wengi wetu tumerealize vitu hatukuwa tunajua, tumepewa medicine, hope tutakuwa poa.
With the aim to not only transform the institution structurally, Gemba had a vision to have a complete transformation in the lives of these children through a number of activities.
We had proposed that we'll be able to take this orphanage and provide transformational change in terms of teaching them how to plant trees, also renovating their hall, and even doing a medical camp. The agenda of this is to just be a part of transformation for the community and to be able to ignite these children. Why did we decide that let it be Riruta? Because at the orphanage we are seeing children from the age of around 6 to 12 years where they're at their prime, or where we can be able to teach them the different learning skills. And one of those skills is the environment, that as we grow the global greenway, that we are trying to impact the environment, also the children can be able to engage, and them being orphans will be able to show them that indeed the opportunities there. We'll give them an example of our lives, what we have gone through, and just showing them that indeed there was transformation, and it doesn't matter where you start, it is how you finish the race.
The need for environmental conservation and food security was met through various measures, including tree planting, horticulture, and kitchen garden. Through all this, the children got an opportunity to learn how to be environmental friendly and also how to take care of their own health.
We cut this with
knife.
With knife or something, eh? unafanya mambo mengine huko. Sikiliza.
Kamtia
kwa mali.
So
mjao kwa wapi? So ameshika haya. Angalieni vile anararua.
We cut this like this. We remove this. You see?
Natoaiwa jua la pole.
Yes. And normally if we had a scissor, we could have cut as it didn't come out. We could have, if the seed is, if the root is coming out,
atizo mizizi,
we will cut it.
Ingekata kama inatoka lazima ikate.
Because that will discourage typical dominance. Oh, and it encourage lateral growth.
Anataka hiyo mizizi iende hivi, isikaende chini kwa sababu ndio ime fit lazima mizizi iende hivi. Kwa hivyo ile mizizi mtapata hapa chini lazima muikate.
Okay?
So whatever,
the need to have a medical camp was prompted by the health status of some of the children who for needy reasons were affected with malnutrition and other diseases.
Okay, I'm born for Skibe from Kiabo County, Likale 45 Hospital. I'm a clinician. I'm happy to be here today to support these children of SIDS, the orphanage. And the first thing, we were targeting to see 100 patients, 100 children, but at least for up to now we were able to manage to see 70 so far. We have reviewed several children, whereby most of them we have realized that they have a skin condition which need to be aggressively managed. And then on the other hand, we have also realized that some of them, they are malnourished, whereby they also need to be supported with a feeding program if they can, but not majority. There are very few who have not met the normal weight. We also realize that we have children who need to be reviewed regularly, like on a monthly basis. If they can get someone who can maybe support them on that, that one will be highly appreciated.
This project was not only on finances and structures, but the members of Gemba realized that it needed more of things that were valueless. This meant that the members got time to engage with the kids on their day-to-day life activities, and they also got to walk through their journey and share their dreams together.
This is week three of activities at Riruta Shade Orphanage. We started with a tree planting exercise with the children because we felt it's important for children to know what happens in the environment, that trees are important for them, and trees actually help to attract the rain. I know they learn all these things in school, but it's also important for them to participate in such an activity. The second week we had sack farming. We realized that most children don't get the necessary nutrients from their diet. Every so often, people will donate cereals, dry foods in the form of beans and maize, but we often forget that they need fresh vegetables as part of their diet. So we came up with a plan to introduce vegetables in an economically and environmentally sustainable manner. So we've helped to plant about 40 sacks of fresh green vegetables. We have the kale, the skumawiki, the spinach, managus, and the children can consume about 15 sacks, and the rest will be harvested for sale. This also improves the economic sustainability of this home. They are able to contribute to their own livelihood by watering the plants, consuming what they can, and selling the rest for an income to manage the day-to-day expenses of the home.
Thank you so much. Do you feel that this project has been a success, or if you had better, more time and better resources, you could have done something better for the orphanage?
I would think that the project has been a success because, to start with, it has implanted something in the mind of the kids. Whether the plants grow or not, the idea would definitely grow in the heads of the children with whom we have been working the project. I also think that the project will definitely succeed because it is about the people who own the project. It's about the people who walks every morning to water and weed that project. And I think the fact that we did not only focus on agriculture, but we also looked at the governance aspect of it. We also went into some infrastructure improvement, like the hall for their meeting and all that. I think it is combined effect of all these different integrated approaches to implementing that project will really take it forward a little bit far for me. Yeah.
Thank you so much. At the beginning, there were ideas that maybe some people would like to adopt some of the kids, some will maybe come back later, maybe to do some things. As at now, are there people who have already pledged or who have already started maybe mentoring other kids or maybe sponsoring some kids?
Mentoring and sponsoring is there. Even like we're talking of health programs and health benefits and also mentoring them to inspire them to be what they would want to be, you know, and achieve their full potential. So there's that also beat, which is very key in the end, that you just don't make one contact, you keep making contacts with the kids and inspiring them to aspire to be better people, to go out there and not feel like they've come from a difficult background, but rather they are there to be whom they are supposed to be.
Thank you so much, Wafula. Finally, do you think, okay, let's compare maybe the transformational leadership in other parts of leadership. What is the main or one of the biggest challenges that you think this system brings on board, and what kind of success that you think is a greater idea from this kind of leadership?
According to what in the Kenyan population, the children are, how can I say, more than the children and the youth are surmounting at least say 60 to 65% of the population, and there are the very few who are being catered for. In terms of leadership, we're seeing people who are much older who are not caring mostly about these children and the youth. And that was the burning point, that these children, in as much as they are many in terms of the population, we should be able to ride on them and their future. And the way that they are vulnerable, we thought that indeed they are the children moving from either childhood to adolescent to teenagehood and even furthermore to adulthood and even being incorporated to the whole community setup. And we thought that if we don't attack the problem from the base, definitely we'll just be removing the branches, but the root is still having issues. And that's the bit where we thought that indeed we need to go back and try and reach them at the place where they are able to be turned or to be transformed, and also engage in them, that they be able to know that they have a right as children, the space is there for them as children, and that was one of the critical issues in terms of the leadership.
The journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. The one step is done, and this leaves a lot to be done. Gemba 2013 hopes to engage in strategic partnerships to be able to continue working with the kids of Riruta Shades Orphanage to realize a complete transformation.
Bye.